Hey everybody, Sean here. Hope you're doing well. The Book of Ezekiel talks about the watchman and warning others, and that's what we'll look at today. Ezekiel 33 is a transition between God's judgments against Israel and the nations in chapter 1 to 32 and Israel's bright future when she is restored to her land in chapters 34 to 48. On first glance, it would appear that it's warning about war, especially when we see the words like sword. But if we continue in the next paragraph, we see it speaking about being spiritual watchmen and warning people of their sins, just like John the Baptist did by telling people to repent. In the first paragraph, it says that whoever hears the sound of the trumpet and does not take warning, if the sword comes and takes him away, his blood shall be on his own head. But if the watchman sees the sword coming and does not blow the trumpet, and the people are not warned, and the sword comes and takes any person from among them, he is taken in his iniquity, his sin, but his blood I will require at the watchman's hand. And we see this mirrored below, saying that if we don't warn the wicked from his way, that wicked man shall die in his sin, but his blood he will require at our hands. So the watchmen are responsible for bringing the attention to non-believers about their sin they may have in their lives. It's not the job to make them repent, but to at least make them aware of it. And while some may have a direct calling to be watchmen or street preachers, we are all responsible to warn non-believers in our lives. If we know the truth and don't tell others, then it's a problem. We know the judgment of God is coming on all unbelievers, and we also know the solution, so it's our duty to warn people. Now, we could dig much deeper on Ezekiel 33, but I'm just going to leave a link here so that you can check it out in your free time. We can even look at this in a New Testament application with chapters like 2 Peter. It talks about false teachers among us that secretly bring in destructive heresies, and that many will follow these people. And if we know the truth of these false teachers, then we must warn others. We see this in Matthew 24. People are going to be led astray. We see in Romans 16 that by smooth talk and flattery, they deceive the naive. And we could go through so many other verses on false teachers, but the fact is that people are and will be deceived unless someone shows them these errors. Discernment is a sign of spiritual maturity, as it says in Hebrews 5:14. And not everybody's there yet. In fact, the whole paragraph dealing with spiritual maturity tells us that many should be teachers by now, but are not and continue to be babes in Christ. They are unskilled in the word of righteousness. I think there's many in these movements that are just listening to their teachers and by not reading their Bibles remain ignorant in the faith. So while not everyone has a calling to develop a discernment ministry, we are all our brother's keepers. We that do know the truth must at least warn those we know of the errors we've discerned. So reflecting back to Ezekiel, if we know of false teaching and we don't warn others of it, we have blood on our hands. As long as we've given the warning, we can wash our hands and live with a clear conscience. So as always, leave your thoughts and comments below, and until next time, take care and God bless.